A history-making moment to avoid Armageddon. NASA announcing its spacecraft successfully pushed an asteroid out of its natural orbit after a deliberate crash last month. This was that DART mission, and its goal was to see if slamming into the asteroid could actually change its course just in case a bigger asteroid one day threatens Earth.
Now, this is a watershed moment for planetary defense and a watershed moment for humanity.
Let's bring in CNN space and defense correspondent Kristen Fisher. All right, it took a while to figure out exactly what happened here. Is it worth it? Is the payoff there?
Yeah, Brianna, you and I have been talking about this for weeks. What we learned yesterday was that this mission was even more successful than NASA expected. We already knew that NASA's DART spacecraft had successfully hit this asteroid, Dimorphos, a little over 2 weeks ago. What we did not know was if NASA had achieved its primary objective, which was to move Dimorphos' orbit just a little bit. Dimorphos orbits this much larger asteroid called Didymos. And so the goal was to kind of push it just a little bit closer to Didymos to see if this technology worked, if they could actually do it. And what they found, Brianna, was just quite shocking because they were expecting to change Dimorphos' orbit by only about 10 minutes. In reality, they were able to change it by 32 minutes. So before impact, the orbit was 11 hours and 55 minutes. After impact, 11 hours and 23 minutes around Didymos. That's a change of about 4%. And Brianna, the way they were able to determine all of this is by using ground-based telescopes, telescopes that you and I are used to on the ground, on planet Earth, like this one that was taken in Chile, the SOAR telescope. So that's why it took a little bit of time, Brianna, for you and I to finally learn what we've been waiting for all this time.
That looks like the More You Know logo, by the way, that picture. I've thought that the whole time. So the goal of this mission, of course, was to see if it was feasible to move a potential Earth-threatening asteroid, a bigger asteroid in the future, without training a ragtag group of oil drillers, including Ben Affleck and Bruce Willis and Steve Buscemi. So what are the next steps in getting to that point? Because they might not be available.
Yeah, well, we've learned that humanity does not need Bruce Willis and Ben Affleck. What we've learned, and there's still a lot left for NASA to learn. Right here, this is an image that NASA released just yesterday. This was taken by the Hubble Space Telescope on Saturday, so almost 2 weeks after impact. And Brianna, look at this trail here. This is 2 weeks after impact, and you can still see this trail of debris coming from the asteroid that stretches about 6,000 miles long. That's kind of the point of impact. That's the trail. And then check out this other image that NASA released yesterday at this briefing. This was taken by the small satellite that was kind of trailing, spying on the DART spacecraft produced by the Italian Space Agency. And that's the moment of impact. And what's really interesting that what NASA wants to study are these big plumes of dust that come out from the moment of impact. So Brianna, what's next? That's the big question here. What NASA has done is they've proven that this type of technology could work. If there were ever a big Earth-killing asteroid potentially headed our way, this one was not. The key here, though, Brianna, is you have to detect it years in advance, far in advance, so that you could send a spacecraft like DART, hit it, and push it just 4% off its current orbit so that ultimately you could move its trajectory by a much larger margin and hopefully save the planet, all of us, the kind of technology that the dinosaurs would have loved, Brianna.
Yeah. They didn't have that lead time in the movie Armageddon, yeah. But that's obviously what you need. This is one of my favorite stories that you've covered, Kristen. Thank you so much for wrapping it all up for us.